Hi everyone, welcome to the Python tutorial. In this tutorial, I'm going to find out the average value of the marks from separate schools. So suppose I have a variable number of schools, and for each school, I have different number of students. I would like to find out the average of a mark for each school having a different number of students, and from the averages from each school, I would like to find out the school with the highest average mark. In the implementation, I would like to control the use of built-in functions to a minimum. Let us see the structure of our list that stores the average, that stores the marks for different schools. I have a list of lists, and in this list of lists, each small list represents the marks from each school. For now, I have four numbers for the first school. So for the first school, there are 9 marks, and for the second school, the number of marks may be less than 9, so I use another list to store the contents. Okay, for another school, there are only 6 marks. I can add one more school, for example, to complete the list. For the third school, there are only 7 marks. So my aim is to find out the average mark for each school first. So I will have 3 average marks for the 3 schools, and from the 3 average marks, I would like to find out the maximum average mark. So how can I do this? Since we need to find out the average mark for each school, we can think about a function to do so. We can call the function getAverage, and the parameter is simply the list here or there or there. Okay. How can we find out the average mark for each list? We have to use the definition of an average, which is the sum of all the values divided by the number of terms. So when I do the cumulative sum, I need a local variable called total, which is now equal to 0. And I will add more values from this list to the total variable, which will become the sum of the numbers contained in the list. Let us see how that works. Okay, mark will be each of the elements in this list, and I will add all the marks all together, and I will store the sum to the total variable. Initially, it is 0, so when I complete this for loop, I will get the sum of all these numbers. We want to find out the average, so we need to do the division. Since there are 9, 6 or 7 elements in a school, I don't really know the number of elements in the list, so I have to use the LEN keyword to help me determine the number of marks in a given school. So this is the average value that I want. After finding out this average, I can return it. Okay, in this case, the function output will be the average value for each list. So in order to store the average marks for coming from each school, I can create a list called average list, which is equal to an empty list for the time being. And then I can loop over each of the tiny list in the whole big mark list. Here, group list is simply equal to each one of the list inside the mark list. Okay. I can call the function. Here, when I put group list into the getAverage function, I'm simply picking these small lists one by one. So when I do the first list, I will put the first list into the getAverage function, and I will have the average of the marks as the return value of this function, and I save this return value to the variable called average value. Then I can save this average value to the average list. So I use the append action to put one more number into the average list. So in my case now, since I have three small lists inside the big list, the number of elements in the average list will be equal to 3. I want to find out the biggest number stored in the average list. How can I do that? I can use a user-defined function to do so. I can create a function here. Suppose the marks for the students are non-negative. I'm very, very sure that the minimum value allowed for the contents in the average list will be 0. A list will be the average list that I'm going to pass to the function. So if I have a value from the list that is larger than the maximum value, I will store that mark as the maximum value for the time being. So I will update the max value to the value that I have found to be the maximum for the time being. After I finished the whole for loop, I will be able to determine the largest value from the elements in this average list. So let us see how we can employ this function to help us find out the maximum average mark. Before doing so, we have to return the maximum value as the function return value. We can call the function here. Yes, this is my intention of using the getMax function to find out the maximum average value of all the three schools here. Then I can do the printing. Are your school here? Here, I'm going to print out the highest average mark for all the schools that I have examined. And I can also print out the maximum average mark that is found according to the getMax method. GetMax function. Okay, I can also print out the school, which gives the highest average. I used index command corresponding to the average list to find out the school index that can give me the highest average. So max average is the mark corresponding to the function output. And when I want to check the index of this element in my average list, I can use the index command to help me. So let us see the result. Okay, for my mark list, I can see that the school 2 gives me the highest average. That means the average mark obtained by these six values would be the highest one. Okay, and the average mark obtained for school 2 is equal to this amount. So I can add more schools in my mark list by adding more list of small list like this. Then I can get the highest average mark for more schools. My implementation may be quite intuitive and straightforward, but it may not be the most efficient solution to the problem. If you can think about any idea of improving my code, please post your idea on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.